Today we're going to look at how to calculate equivalent spring constant. In this video, we're going to cover two types of common setup that you will see often in system modeling. The first one we're going to see is spring in parallel. Here is the setup. We have two springs here. For each of them, one side is connected to a fixed wall and the other side is connected to a mass. Geometrically, these two springs are side by side, and we call them in parallel. The mass is allowed to move only in x direction, and we define going to the right is positive. From class, we have learned that when springs are connected like this, we can find an equivalent system with only one spring that has the same performance. And we have learned that this equivalent spring constant k equals to k1 plus k2. So now we're going to examine if this relationship is true. How to examine it? We'll build two systems exactly look like how it shows in the screen now. One with two springs in parallel, the other one equivalent with only one spring, and the spring has an equivalent spring constant equals to the sum of k1 and k2. Then we will let both of them oscillate and see if the masses have the same motion. To make them oscillate, we'll first pull the masses to the right at delta x distance from their equilibrium position, and then release them. Both systems have no friction, and therefore they should be freely oscillating afterwards. If you're not familiar with free oscillation, please review the video on that topic. Now, how can we tell if both systems behave the same? Well, we know the spring constant determines the period of oscillation. Frequency omega equals to square root of k over m. K is the spring constant and m is the mass. Then the period of oscillation equals to 2 pi over omega, and therefore period has an expression t equals to 2 pi times square root of m over k. So we can monitor if both of the systems have the same period. The simulation is set up in working model 2D. The measurement windows are going to monitor the position of the masses. These two bars control the spring constant of each of the parallel springs, and this bar controls the equivalent spring constant. Now let's set K1. Let's call it K1 equals to 10 newton per meter, and K2 is set to be, let's say, 20 newton per meter. And then the equivalent spring constant should be 10 plus 20 equals to 30 newton per meter. So let's change this equivalent spring constant to 30 newton per meter. And now let's run it. So you can see both systems are freely oscillating now, and they are in sync. Since both of the masses were pulled 0.5 meter to the right from equilibrium, their amplitude, which were calculated from peak to valley, are the same. We can also compare the period with our theoretical calculation. With the equation we just derived, the mass is 10 kilogram, equivalent spring constant is 30 newton per meter. The period of the oscillation should be 3.63 seconds. And you can see from the measurement, the period is about, from peak to peak, it's about 3.5 seconds. Of course, you can export the data and do a more accurate analysis. Now let's try another combination. Let's change K2 to 50 newton per meter, and then the equivalent spring constant should accordingly change to 10 plus 50 equals to 60 newton per meter. And now let's see what's going to happen. So you can see the oscillation become much faster because according to our equation, the period should be shorter. Again, both motions are in sync. You can set up this simulation by yourself and try some different combinations.